All of our videos are available to repost for educational purposes.
This is a quick interview, the next 30 minutes or so. We're going to get him back up for a full hour in the near future. But I wanted to get Bob Fletcher's take on why government is running around like a chicken with its head cut off, trying to gear up for war with people, not just here, but in every other country. Is it the world economic meltdown? Is it the derivatives overhang? Is it QE unlimited? But I wanted to get Bob's take as well, if you just joined us. Bob Fletcher, businessman, inventor, film producer, speaker, and author. After years of business as a professional career, Bob became involved in the U.S. government top secret covert arms sales. He's testified as a top witness to Iran-Contra. His company basically got infiltrated by the CIA, taken over as a front company. And Bob Fletcher Investigations.com is his site. And we've told your story, Bob. I just wanted to get your take today, and then we'll get into why you think they're gearing up for all this. I wanted to get your take on the state of the world, what's happening, how crazy it is. 91% in Reuters poll against the war. So that's good news. I see an awakening happening on one end, but the crazies run things, and then the rest of the public are zombies. And I just have a feeling of dread for, and everybody else I talk to that's a business person or successful or informed, they have the same sense that we're about to witness biblical things, basically. Bob Fletcher.
Right. Well, that part I absolutely agree with. And, you know, last night I was watching with my wife. We were watching the introductions on a whole slew of the new television programs. Completely garbage. I mean, it embarrasses me. It embarrasses me that my fellow Americans would even watch the garbage that they're producing to infiltrate their brain and fill it with trash so that they don't even recognize what's going on. Like what you're talking about, the access to the sports and all of that ridiculous, God bless you if you're supporting your team, you know, but don't spend 5 days leading up to a football game. You know, what happened to your kids, what happened that week to your family, and what happened to the world while you were out there trying to buy the extra couple of six packs of beer to throw into your RV to go to the football game 5 days down the road. I mean, it's absolutely insane. I can't understand how successful the bad guys in government have been in the last 35 years in turning our entire American culture into sponge brains. It's unbelievable. It's embarrassing, personally shocking and embarrassing. Now, as you know, I have been chasing bad guys in government for 35 years or something like that at this point in time, the entire second last half of my life. And and after being involved with a multitude of investigations out of the Senate and the Congress and being a federal witness a couple of times and a whistleblower on multitude of times, unfortunately not having anybody of sufficient strength to listen to any of us. You know, being a whistleblower is fine, but if nobody hears the whistle, it doesn't matter, I guess. But I've been doing that for years and years. And it became a regular recognized thing that people were stealing multiple millions of dollars if you had a foot or a finger in the pie in Washington, D.C. Somehow you and your buddy could get away with a few million bucks. You could always get an extra couple of a few thousand bucks for this and that, a couple of million bucks for an extra whatever project maybe your family wanted to do and things of that sort if you were had your finger in the pie and had a friend inside, all right? And that became regular. The theft of a few million here and a few million there didn't mean very much. But then I recognized a while back that we were talking billions of dollars disappearing. And then, believe it or not, it became recognized that it was trillions of dollars.
$2.2 trillion missing from the Pentagon alone. As of 2001.
That's correct. But to put the icing on the cake, how about the $9 trillion on from the Federal Reserve that just vanished, and it vanished apparently. Now, wait a minute. Now, I'm going to say that again. $9 trillion. The Senate and the Congress investigated and asked, directly the investigative branch, the lady that was in charge of theoretically doing maintaining audits and maintaining oversight on the Federal Reserve. And she was asked directly, what about $9 trillion on off-the-books indicated money with the Federal Reserve that vanished someplace into European banks?
I remember that. We've played that clip. In fact, that clip is in Fall of the Republic. Exactly. So they can steal trillions. Why not arm Al-Qaeda publicly? Why not have Obama sign an order that he can arm Al-Qaeda like he did 2 weeks ago? They just do whatever they want. So
it's mind-boggling. And this lady now, she was one, and she was the, what do they call it,
the auditor.
Missing the word. But anyhow, she was in charge of oversight, doing potentially any oversight auditing of what was going on. And they said, are you investigating that? The fact that there apparently is $9 trillion disappeared into European banks someplace. And she said, well, we don't call it an investigation. We like to look into it, but I'm not sure what you're talking about. And, of course, she really did. But she was kind of stuck that somebody had even asked
her. So bottom line, what's going to happen?
All right, so what we're looking at is trillions of money's disappearing, billions and trillions. The gold is all gone out of Fort Knox. If anybody thinks there's $1.35 worth of gold left in there, because when you had foreign nations ask for their own gold back, the United States told them it would take 7 years before they could give them an audit. So the gold is gone from Fort Knox, trillions disappearing from major financial institutions. And so you have to say, where can it go? Because you can't steal that much and hide it. You cannot launder $1 trillion. That's a physical impossibility. Now, if you are the government and you are building hundreds of underground facilities, which is going on, and you are assisting the Russians to build 5,000 of them underground, and the other nations of the world, you're assisting with our tax dollars to build underground facilities, and they are putting in multi-millions of dollars into weapons to shoot rioters on the street. They're spending all this money cutting deals with Russia to bring over extra people to assist in the time of need.
They're training 24/7 for open war against us. It's high treason.
Okay, now, so I had to sit back and I said, well, wait a minute, what's going on? So, of course, then with just a little more inquiry, a little more snooping, and a few more people coming to you from under the table, the bottom line is simply this. They are fully anticipating a catastrophic celestial impact. That's the terminology they used when they were cutting the deal with the Russians to bring assistance over here when needed for FEMA, for the federal emergency. They are anticipating a celestial impact. I happen to know, and by the way, all of this is on a new video that I'm trying to get out. I've never had so much trouble in my life. I've had entire computers burn up on me in the last 7 months on this thing, literally. They're doing a number on me to stop me.
By the way, it's funny you mention that, because they admit that's the plan to set up world government is for a defense system against asteroids. So I want to get your inside take on that. But Bob, this is a short segment. I want to ask you right now, is your gut telling you something's wrong? Because, I mean, they don't care if nuclear reactors are melting down now. They used to care. They used to care and not let troops use DU. Now they don't care. I mean, it's like the devil runs things and they're persecuting all forms of goodness. I mean, I know they've got an underground base program that's for nuclear war and they say it's for asteroids. And I mean, I know all that's going on and you have sources on it, but it seems like there's something else going on.
Well, you know, primarily that's it. What it is, they had all of a sudden discovered, and it was let's put it this way, it was a vague possibility a while back that there was going to be, that this 10th planet, the Nibiru, Planet X, whatever you want to call it, was potentially way out there and it's going to come back and make a circle through. All right, well, that was kind of close to Earth. And that was kind of a maybe possibility kind of a thing. But someplace around 1983, and it was verified by a central intelligence person, friend of mine out of Washington, at such a high level this particular agent used to write speeches for Reagan and Bill Casey, with Bill Casey for a long time, head of the CIA. anyhow, the bottom line was that about 83 sometime in that period of time, they had some kind of a confirmation that, hey, this thing is coming back, and it's going to take a few years. It might take 20 years or so, but it absolutely will be coming back. And they started at that point in time expanding the underground facilities and all of that. And it's got nothing to do with nuclear or anything. What it has to do in reality, all of this, and what irritates me more than anything is they have kept all this totally secret from the general public. They've lied and covered up about it and said, oh, no, it was this, that, and the other thing. But they have taken every single possible dollar bill and gold bar that they can, and it is gone. It's out of here. And it has either been directly applied to the construction of these hideout survival facilities for the limited few.
And by the way, it's been coming out in the news. What are these giant concrete fortresses in the Ozarks and other areas? And then it turns out there's bases under them, and they're really like an underground train station, above ground terminal. That's what I've been told by people involved in the construction.
Oh, that particular construction you're talking about, by 72,000 square feet, it's registered as a private party home. The guy's a central intelligence operative and a genius that has put together many of the spy electronic operations that are used by our military. That's the fellow. His name's Stephen Huff. He's the fellow that owns this particular large construction. It is the fourth largest house in the United States. It makes Bill Gates' place look like an outhouse.
Truth is, he was given the NSA satellite patents on a bunch of stuff to be given tens of billions, but he's really just the front for a government operations, my information.
Most likely, that's exactly the situation. Now, where his home is located, which is over top of this multi-thousand miles of tunnels under the ground, which I was told about in 95. I got some pictures of it in 95. Didn't believe it. And have been pursuing it ever since. It's absolutely a reality. The tunnels, there's so many tunnels under the United States with these connecting things. It's like a spider web of tunnels beneath the ground. Now, here's the bottom line. They've taken all of this money, every cent that belongs to the United States taxpayers. They totally kept it secret. They are absolutely awaiting the incoming of this huge... 10th planet is what it amounts to be. It's in this gigantic, huge orbital configuration. Takes it like 3,000 years to come around.
And it's in the Kuiper Belt. Well, then what about all the false starts where they said it was going to come a decade ago and all that?
I can't account for all of that. I know some of it's misinterpretation of different things. But watching the way the budgeting has been going with them all of a sudden rushing bullets and weapons, buying that up by billions of dollars of weapons to control riots.
You know, Bob Fletcher is a really smart guy. And I know that it was Lyndon LaRouche that went and met with Reagan and others. That's when George Bush Sr. got really, really jealous. This all came out. You can pull this up in the Washington Post. I know the media has discredited Lyndon LaRouche. So you hear that name, like, Lyndon LaRouche, isn't that the guy that's a right-winger or a left-winger or the guy that paints Hitler mustaches on Obama? And you can say what you want about the LaRouche movement. I don't agree with some of their aims, but their analysis is spot on. He was in meetings with the head of the CIA in the 80s over and over again, and with Reagan, which made the whole power structure very jealous. And they said, put SDI up for an anti-meteor program. And I know then, because LaRouche said it on air, they were very concerned about comets, other things that we know, especially since Shoemaker Levy, when they discovered that comet and then predicted accurately that it would hit one of the super gas giants. Was it Jupiter or Saturn? I always get it hit Jupiter. I always get that factoid backwards, that it blew like giant holes bigger than the Earth and the gas giant. The point is that I have seen their concern about that, but that really they were going to use space-based weapon systems. The cover would be a defensive system. And I know the U.S. and Russia have had meetings at the U.N. I'm just backing up what Fletcher's saying. And they claim they're building underground bases in COG, that's continuity of government systems, for comets, asteroids. I think the term Planet X has become more of a archetype of all this debris. We know there's hundreds of planetoid-sized spheres moon size and smaller out in the Kuiper Belt that they've now picked up with radio telescopes. A lot of them supposedly have these elliptical orbits and do come through. And the ancients all recorded these things coming close. And, you know, then you get mountains shooting up 1,000 feet in the air and lava spraying out. Previously, they thought every 10 million years or something, a big asteroid hit the Earth. We now know they're thinking it's every couple hundred. And so they think they're on time to have this. I think it's Planet X, because I heard about it in 99, 2003. I always thought it was baloney, that it was going to hit us. And, of course, Bob didn't say it was going to hit us then. My point is kind of an excuse for COG. I'm not disagreeing with you that they're concerned about it, Bob. I just think the CIA guy, high level, that was telling you this might have been putting a false story on you, partially false, or he may have been fed it himself. Do you get my point I'm making?
Yeah, but that's not all right, but you don't even have the very weakest scratch surface. You can't imagine how much real statistics are on this. All right. First off, the solar flare situation. All right, it's been acknowledged by NASA. Not that this is an 11-year cycle. The solar flares have been the most outrageous they have been in 1,000 years. But that's solar flares. That's being affected already by Nibiru, by Planet X. Planet X is estimated to be 5 times the size of Earth. Woolsey, James Woolsey, head of the CIA, been out a couple of years. A few months ago, he said, there is no question in our mind that we will have a solar flare with the potential, or several of them, the potential to shut down all electronics on either the Earth or half of the globe.
That's right. Nibiru is supposed to be bigger than Jupiter, correct?
It's 5 times the size of Earth. It's probably the size of Jupiter.
I think Jupiter's like 300 times.
The point is, it will pass around, it will come close, it'll go around the sun, and we will run through the tail of this thing, which has like 4,000 miles of garbage. So we have so many meteorites and potential small pieces of junk hitting us. Why have we had? We have already had more meteorites than we usually do in 5 years in the world in the last 2 years. That's also already being affected by Nibiru coming back.
Wait a minute. I got to stop you right now. And my wife is a witness to this. And I just entered Twilight Zone. I was down at the beach at just some funky condominiums we go and rent for 2 or 3 days ago fishing down in Port Aransas. And a guy comes and knocks on my door and he said he was going to email it to Dew. Go see if he emailed it to Dew. Because I gave him his email because I always miss stuff. I never check mine. The point is, I might as well not even have email. He comes and knocks on my door and says, I want to send you these photos that I took. And he was bringing up Planet X to me, and he was saying, look at this. This was taken in Austin a week ago. It's funny I ran into you here. I thought it was really weird. And he was showing me photos of in broad daylight, and it wasn't a sun flare because he showed me video.
No.
And I could see it from behind the tree, so it wasn't a sun flare. But that could be anything. I mean, that could be a satellite. Who knows?
That's correct. But I have, and most of them are on my new video. I'm hoping to get the darn thing out. I don't even know if it'll get out. That's how much trouble they've had. The bottom line is we have pictures of it, particularly stuff taken from the southern Antarctic, the weather center down there. They've got pictures from down there. There's pictures from all over the world, progressively, et cetera, et cetera. There's no question about that. Google Space, about 1 year ago, when it was posted out by somebody that was an astronomer, said, go to this on Google Space, and you can find it. The following day, they literally blacked it out the size of a postcard so that you couldn't even see it. They actually intentionally eliminated it from people being able to see it. No, it exists, period. Now, I have to go on with this. The lady that's been in charge of the Homeland Security for so long, all right? She just quit a little while back. What's her name? Napoliano, Janet Napoliano. She said the same thing that Woolsey said. that it is absolutely positive we are going to get solar flares that will potentially shut down every single electronic device on either the entire Earth or half of the Earth. Other gentleman that used to be in charge of what they call that psychic thing with the CIA for so long, the viewers, his name was Major Ed Dames. He came out and said the same thing, that they had projected that, in fact, we were going to get these solar flares. Now, the flares are ahead of the possibility of Nibiru coming close. If the solar flares hit us, I want everybody to understand this. If we get a solar flare equal to one that we already got in 1895, when we didn't have a lot of electricity, if we get a solar flare today, it'll put every single mechanism on Earth null and void. We will not have any communication. We will have no lights. We will have no food sources. We'll have no fuel, no method of delivery.
Well, let me say this. It may not be this giant gas giant or this imploded sun, as people have surmised this Planet X or Nibiru is, that the ancients called it. But here's Huffington Post Science. Comet Icen 2013 may be among brightest ever seen, astronomers say. And they go on to say that its tail may hit us, but it's nothing to worry about. I do know they've been in the news saying they believe there's a 100-plus-year cycle and that it will fry all our communications. Now, I don't know if that's government fear-mongering, but you're right. Napolitano has come out and said that. Are you saying they're trying to get people ready for something?
Well, here's the bottom line. Again, they set themselves up. Like I said, they've taken every single dollar they could humanly take. They are either hiding some of the gold for later potential use underground. They're building the undergrounds to hide out for the limited few. Now, what they're going to do is they have to have a martial law before this hits the fan, before it looks like we're going to be completely electronically shut down, and also before, if the possibility of this huge planet swinging close by once more, which it theoretically does every 3,000 years. Now, they have to have some excuse. So some of the junk that we're seeing going on, the crazy, radical, challenging Syria and pushing North Korea and all these other things that potentially any one of which they can cultivate far enough along to where they can declare martial law, and it has to be done before the planet hits the fan, okay? It has to be done. Now, they would not be doing all of this. They've interrupted an awful lot of what we would call the New World Order movement. They've interrupted an awful lot. All of a sudden, and gotten very seriously with going underground and stealing the money. All right, they wouldn't do that if they weren't absolutely positive that the planet was going to hit the fan. Now, I have unbelievable scientific backup on this planet X. Not only do we have great photographs of it now. Now that we have the equipment to do it pretty good, which even includes some what we would call amateur astronomers, but we have statements, et cetera, and going way, way back, and corresponding information. But here's one, again, there's something that I discovered just because I got into this thing and was wondering if this was really possible. The planets in our entire solar system have started heating up, temperature increases, and their orbits are wiggling. They are being affected from Pluto out. In other words, from Pluto coming inwards, but they're heating up from Pluto coming inwards. They are not being heated up by the sun. And this is a scientific fact that's been going on. All of the surface atmosphere, the chemical structure, and the heat, the temperature of all of our planets started a year or so ago going up and started being affected by some body out there beyond Pluto. And that is exactly what we're talking about. We're talking about Nibiru, and we're talking about something that swings through here every 3,600 years. And when it comes close to the Earth, it's going to clean it off like Noah's flood, because that was one of the passes of Nibiru. That was Noah's flood. And it's going to do a number, and it'll do a number on us ahead of actually being close enough to physically do it with its gravitational.
And when do you think this is going to happen?
Sometime beginning yesterday and probably the first of next year. I don't think, according to the ancient writings on the from the Himalayas, from the monks up on the top of the hills in the Himalayas, they talked about 2015. I'm saying sometime between, and the reason I say yesterday, because 5 days ago was some of the contracts that the government had put out, for example, for 2,700 riot control trucks and Jeep tanks. 2,700 of them were to be finished and delivered 5 days ago. I'm assuming that they have been. So I'm taking schedules of a multitude of directions here, not only ancient writings, but modern science.
Well,
and
Bob,
the government's contract.
Very interesting. We'll have to talk to you when that film comes out. We'll talk again soon. Bob Fletcher, investigations.com. Thank you, Bob.
Thank you.
Folks, I like Bob, and he put out a lot of good info on Iran-Contra. Everything he's talking about, we pulled up the article where $9 trillion missing from the Federal Reserve. You know, Newsmax, with her testimony. In fact, I was reminded of that by him. I mean, 99% of what he's saying I can document. Then he goes off into this stuff, and I believe him. I believe he was told this is coming. A lot of what he said, I've separately seen even in mainline news that the CIA has been worried about this. And I believe this is used as a cover, though, for the whole COG program. And they use the threat of solar flares that's real and the threat of comets hitting us that are real. You've got all these cases in Russia 100 years ago and others where thousands of square miles of stuff gets devastated. Thank God nobody was up there in Siberia when it happened, or very few people. I don't discount these things happen. All the time asteroids come close to the Earth. All the time comets come close. It's been proven now that they have telescopes that stuff's getting hit all the time. Look at the moon. You know, they said, oh, that happened over 4 billion years. And now they're like, actually, we think the whole face of it might change every 100 million. The truth is, they don't know. They don't know. We don't know. And it is sensational. I could write a book on Planet X, probably sell a million copies of it. Then all my problems would be solved. I could fund my news operation. But that's not how I'm going to do it. I spent so much time trying to fund the radio show, the filmmaking, the writers, the research, trying to be credible. And then there's just, it's so fantastical what's going on. Who knows what to believe anymore? We'll get Bob back up to talk more about that. I wanted to get Bob up about his take on what's happening in the Middle East, Syria, all that. But, you know, Bob's now gone off into this. And he was the first guy I ever heard talk about with specifics of HAARP and weather manipulation and chemtrails. In like 1993, he was putting out videos on it. And then I thought, this guy's crazy. I remember the first time I saw Bob on like access television in like 1993. I was right out of high school. Had moved out, was in college, and I remember seeing this guy giving reports from wherever he was in Idaho or something, and you know, it was just a video and him talking with charts and stuff about how they did it and the towers and who his witnesses were and when it was developed, and all of that turned out to be accurate. So I'll tell you, it really freaks me out when he's on there saying stuff like that. But I just, I know how many amateur astronomers there are, folks, because I've been one myself. It's mainly amateur astronomers that end up finding things. It is amateur astronomers that find most of the new comets, that find most of the new asteroids. So if there was some big gas giant that was going to be coming out from an elliptical orbit to hit the Earth or come close to the Earth, you would see it. You would know about it. They cannot hide this stuff anymore. So I've got to say that I disagree with Bob overall in the final equation. that Planet X is real. And people have got really mad at me the last three times it was supposed to kill us. And I get if there's ancient stories of this in all cultures. I know things hit the Earth. I'm not debating that. I know there's a bunch of planetoids out there, red dwarfs, black dwarfs, imploded suns, whatever. I'm not debating that that could exist. I'm saying this whole COG is about worldwide financial meltdown and World War III with Russia. Those 11 Russian ships, missile cruisers in the Mediterranean are real. Our ships masked are real. The Joint Chiefs blocking Obama from trying to start a big war, that's real. Saudi Arabia funding Al-Qaeda all over the world. Israel supporting it, just unbelievable, that's real. This is all real. And I'm going to stick to what's real. I don't blame people speculating, and I hope Bob turns out being wrong, too. I think he's a good guy, though. We'll be right back.
All of our videos are available to repost for educational purposes.